So today we're going to be talking about snaps. I happen to use snaps every time I draw, especially while sketching. They're super helpful, especially for circles. That's what I use it most for. So the snaps, you can find them up here on the top right corner. You can also find them under the snap tab up here on the top of the window. I don't know if my screen records it, but you'll find it up on the top. You can also just click a number. You see how they're assigned numbers. So one is off, two is parallel, crisscross, whatever, right? So for example, if you want to draw a straight line, you can just click the crisscross snap and you'll see it'll look like a grid. And no matter where you draw or how, do you hear that? How squiggly you draw, it's going to come out as a straight line. This isn't the only way to draw a straight line. You can actually hold down the shift key. You click and then you hold down the shift. See? But the only thing is that there's no pen pressure. So if you want pen pressure, you just, there you go. Notice, there you go. Light and then heavy and then light again. So I like to use that for straight lines. You can also, for straight lines, use the diagonal snap, which is this one right here. I think it's number 2. And there we go. To change the direction that the diagonal lines are going, click up here to the, what is it called? Let me check. I don't know what it's called. It's like the point one up here. So notice how when I drag my mouse, it kind of changes direction. I click a direction that I want, so let's say I want it to go this way, and then I just click down, and it stays like that. And then you got this direction, which is super fun. I don't use this, actually I lied, I use this all the time. Let's see. Number 4 is the vanishing point. So you're gonna have to, I'll get a new layer. Click where you want the vanishing point to be, so I'm gonna put it up here. And then you're gonna drag it somewhere. And then you're gonna get another point, see how it has the cross again. I'm gonna click out here. There you go. And I drag it back to the vanishing point, and then it kinda has all these lines, so like if I was gonna draw a road going off to the distance, you would have to start from the outside and then draw it towards the vanishing point. I stress that you start from the outside towards the vanishing point, because if you start from the vanishing point and draw to the outside, it might not go the direction that you wanted it to go. Like, I'm gonna try to go this way, right? So yeah, it went the opposite direction. It didn't really work. So you have to start from the outside and go inside. Snap number 5 is, what is this called? The radial, is that how you pronounce it? I use this a lot for, you know, that kind of like sun, the sunlight thing, right? You'll see. So there's my point, but like I said, you can just change the point by clicking on the little point button and you can drag it anywhere. I'm gonna drag it to the center. Then you start from the outside again and you go towards the point. There you go, see? I like to use this for backgrounds a lot, for lots of GIFs I make, for whatever. I'm just gonna leave it like that because I'm lazy. Look how fun that is. Look at that. Oh, that's beautiful. So the next snap I'm gonna talk about is the one I use most often, which is number 6, the circle snap. So I use this for sketching a lot when I'm drawing eyes or heads. It comes up with a bunch of guidelines for circles. You kind of just figure out what size you want. You click and then you just draw. Now, I know it looks a bit janky, right? Everywhere, this whole thing looks a little not so good, but that's only because I'm recording my screen, and whenever I record my screen, lines turn out kind of janky, which is why I never show my line art process during my speed paints. I promise that if you tried this on your own, the circles are gonna come out super smooth and super beautiful, and it's just, that one's not too bad, see? The last snap we're going to be talking about is the curve snap, which is number 7. It's right there. So it's pretty much like the curve line tool, I think, on any other art program. So you're going to be given the cross, and you're going to click points. See how it's kind of like mapping out your curve? So you can do that for as many points as you want, and when you're done with however, you know, when you figure out how many points you need, you just double click and it shows you that right there. Don't have to explain it. You can drag it anywhere. You can make it smaller or bigger if you didn't get the size right. And then whenever you're happy with the size or whatever, you just, there you go. You use your brush tool and there it is. Let me see. Click exit. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh. Oh, that's beautiful. I don't really use this very often because I just learned how to use it as I was recording. But I'll probably use it now for certain things. Look at this. Look at that almost perfect circle that would be perfect if I wasn't recording. See? And then you just... Oof. Oh, it's a face. See? It's perfect. It's perfect for sketching. Well, that's all I had for this video. I hope it helps a little bit. And I hope these videos convince you to use FireAlpaca because I think it's a really, really great program. I don't know what else to tell you. I mean, it's free. I don't know. Why don't you guys like free things? It's free. What is that? That's not an ear. If you have any suggestions for other videos, mostly, you know, like art related or Fire Alpaca related, just ask me and I might make a video about it if I'm comfortable with it, because I'm not comfortable with lots of things. I am a very uncomfortable person. Ooh, too big. Too big. That's too small. There we go. I really wish that's too big. I really wish that these would come out more smooth because they look super janky right now and you guys probably aren't really into it, but I promise you it's just because of my screen recording. If I wasn't recording, they would be super smooth. See? There we go. Oh, so angry. Okay. I'm done. Wait, let's see. Oh, there we go. There, yes. Wink. That doesn't look like it belongs on the same face. Okay, I'm done. Thank you. Bye. I love you.